this week on The Golf Club, an adventure in paradise as we enjoy the delights of Bali, Indonesia and the Meridian Nirwana Resort. And James Slade's Nike Golf Tip.
I'm going to show you how to play the shot when you're playing into the green.
The tropical paradise of Bali has long been an exotic attraction for tourists wishing to bask in the warmth and beauty of one of the most tranquil islands in the world. And the Meridian Nirwana Resort, situated on Bali's southwest coastline, is the perfect haven for those looking to enjoy the island's rich cultural history while enjoying a top international golf course. From sprawling views of the lively coastline to the serenity of the course-side rice paddy fields, the Meridian experience offers a true taste of the wonders of the equatorial paradise and is just 45 minutes from the island's international airport. And with all the island wonders within easy reach, there's certainly plenty of activities available for the variety of Bali vacationers.
Well, there's so much to do on Bali, from soft adventure to golf to beaches. There's a lot of culture, the people are fantastic, and it's a real difference from where most people are coming from.
The Meridian Resort is set in 100 hectares, providing luxury accommodation, magnificent gardens and pools, and a selection of dining and conference facilities that we'll take a closer look at later in the show. For many, however, the main attraction at Le Meridian is the island's top international golf course, managed by IMG Asia. Designed by Greg Norman and enjoyed by the world's best, Le Meridian is truly memorable.
Well, certainly the results you see here are part of a long-time collaboration between the Bakri Group, quite famous in Indonesia for their resorts, and, of course, Greg Norman Design. Started back in 1994 when Greg Norman was secured to design the project. And you can see today's result, which opened in 1997.
And the rich Bali scenery certainly adds value to a course that provides a real challenge for both high and low handicappers. There are certainly a variety of sites on display from one nine to the next.
That was always a big topic of debate, how we arranged the nines once the course was finally completed. The inward nine certainly routes you along a lot of parkland style with the indigenous rice paddies flanking most of the holes. And then the back nine really takes you out along the ocean with some spectacular views and certainly a little more of the link style shot making.
But with views such as these, it's always important to remember your best golf can only be played if you keep your eye on the ball.
One of the things we find is the most interesting when we survey the players and ask them, what do you think of the condition of the golf course? They quite often look out and around and go, oh, it's beautiful, when really we're asking them about the tees and the greens and the fairways.
And the opening hole is one of designer Greg Norman's favorites.
Obviously, the opening hole on any great resort course sets the tone, and certainly here Norman did that with number one. You'll see the indigenous rice paddies down the left side with a little bit of elevation change, which routes the player who will be hitting probably a driver for your average resort player from the shark tees, which is about 383 from the back, or a three wood for your better player, to a little plateau about three quarters of the way up to the green. Provided you've been able to get it to the plateau, avoiding the heavy bunkering on the left-hand side, you'll have about a little mid-iron to wedge for the better player to the green. However, the green, you must be very careful, because running along the back of the green is a sneaky little stream that'll gobble up any golf balls that go long or left on this hole.
Our next stop is the longest par four on the course.
Now you head into the heart of the front nine. Number four, which was originally thought about of possibly being number 18 because of the tough green sight, features a very undulating green for a mid-iron approach shot, and don't hit it right there because it slopes far and away down to the number one fairway. Escaping there with a par on the longest par four on the course, most resort players are going to be very happy. Number five, probably one of the most dramatic and intimidating tee shots. You'll face a temple on the right-hand side, which are prominent throughout the golf course, and it's very tight up the left-hand side, a very narrow driving area, flanked by bunkers on the left as well. So now you've made it through five, past the temples, and you head to perhaps the most dramatic par five on the course. Norman left several options available here, including cutting the corner and going for the green in two. However, most players will find themselves hopefully in the middle of the fairway with considering a long wood or a layup shot with a mid-iron to try and birdie the hole. The final approach to the green doesn't get any easier. A two-tiered green that drops away on the right with some heavy bunkering and, of course, the backdrop of the ocean, taking your mind away off the shot at hand.
Approaching the seventh hole and you realize the true beauty of this wonderful Balinese coastline. The famous Tanalot Temple is in full view, while the challenging tee shot is bound to keep your mind firmly on the job ahead.
Now you've made it to our signature hole, featuring the Tanalot Temple, which is the most famous temple in Bali. 184 yards from the shark tee, and two real challenges here. First, the carry across the ocean, of course, and secondly is drawing your attention away from the dramatic view. Believe it or not, Norman did try to catch a lot of the wayward shots so they didn't float down or sink down into the ocean below. There is actually more room than it appears over there, but certainly visually intimidating from the tee. So clearing it takes at least a shot of 150 yards. We give you more than challenges just off the tee here at Nirwana Bali Golf Club, and certainly this green is no exception. It does slope severely from the back to the front, so that even hitting it on the green doesn't necessarily guarantee a two-putt and an escape with a par.
With the challenges of the first nine over, it's not so long before the course's hardest challenge is set before you.